Hello, and welcome to another international episode of Furries in the Media, the series that takes a look at media that features furries and reviews them based on how the furry fandom is represented. I'll be your host, Abergwine the Fox. Hey Sam, Christmas is just around the corner and our fans have all been very good this year, so what episode do you think I should review for them? Your fans have been begging you to do World of Weird. You should do that one. World of Weird? Let me think about it first. Okay, I'll do it! I'll do World of Weird! Today's merry episode of Furries in the Media hails across the pond from the UK, Channel 4's World of Weird.
One example is the cultural phenomenon of furries, people who identify with animals so much that they create and dress up in their own animal personas, or fursonas.
Furries are generally defined by their interest in cartoon animals, but fursuiters are defined by the fact that they wear fursuits. Not every furry is a fursuiter or even owns a fursuit, but with very few exceptions, every fursuiter is a furry. The two are not exactly interchangeable.
Furry fandom, as it's known, is based on anthropomorphic animals. That's animals with human qualities to you and me.
Well, that's a good, simple definition of anthropomorphic animals. Good job!
It's now so popular around the world that conventions will attract well over 5,000 people at a time.
Yeah, some of the larger conventions easily bring in thousands of people.
Alex has been a furry for 7 years and lives in paradise, the home he shares with 4 other animals.
Yeah, shared homes like this one are not unheard of in the fandom.
I started by asking Alex why he dresses as a friendly red dragon.
Well, what it all boils down to is we love to have a great time, just some good clean fun. And the best way that we have found to do it, given that we have a distinct interest in animals, is we like pretending to be them.
That's pretty much why furries do what they do. Furries are folks who have an interest in cartoon animals, and they express this interest through whatever method suits them best.
What was your background before this?
Before, I had joined the United States Marine Corps, and I just was a military service member.
Yeah, I don't think it's a conflict of interest for military personnel to also be involved in the furry fandom. The two are not necessarily mutually exclusive. Some people use their involvement in the furry fandom as a way to relieve stress from their daily life, much like many people do after they've ended their workday, and I only imagine that would go double for someone doing something as stressful as serving in the military.
It's quite funny to me that we're going to be spending the whole day together, and I'm only ever going to see you as Chance, never Alex.
I honestly think that when you see this, you're seeing more of me than you would be if you were seeing Alex.
To quote Oscar Wilde, "Man is least himself when he talks in his own person. Give him a mask and he will tell you the truth." It doesn't seem that people can easily separate themselves from their own image, therefore people always have to be aware and cautious of how they present themselves to the world. Wearing a costume could offer a temporary break from this need for keeping up one's appearances.
Can I try on one of those heads?
Absolutely! Yeah, if you want to grab that one.
Oh. And it'll be a snug.
Does it suit me?
It very much suits you. She's so cute.
Do you feel like you're speaking to someone different now that I've got
Absolutely,
this on?
Absolutely, yeah.
How do you feel now that you've got your head on? Do you feel different?
I feel like a cute little dog, yeah.
I think I'm nearly ready to get fully furried.
Okay.
Generally, the point of any costume is for the wearer to assume a new role. Theatrical costumes help an actor to take on the role of a specific character. A sports mascot represents the abstract concept of team spirit, or even a Halloween costume allows the wearer to express a side of themselves that they normally wouldn't in their daily life. That's really all it is when a furry puts on a fursuit.
I really enjoyed wearing the head. It felt silly, and I think that's the whole point of it. I'm looking forward to getting the whole outfit on.
There has to be something to it if a non-furry can put on a full fursuit or even just the head and feel differently than they did before. This is not just something that only furries can experience. What the hostess has just experienced is exactly why many fursuiters say that wearing a fursuit is liberating.
Although good fun, it turns out that dancing around in the sun in a huge furry suit has its drawbacks.
It's so hot under here, you can't even imagine.
Ugh. These outfits shouldn't be shared because I'm wet underneath here, like I'm dripping wet. It's going to be really embarrassing to give this back.
It looks like it's already a pretty warm day they're filming on, and even if it wasn't, wearing a fursuit does indeed get hot very quickly.
Nice to meet you. When did you start doing this?
I started doing this about 3 years ago, and it's changed my life, really. I was really shy. I was afraid to talk to people. After I got this costume, I performed in front of a crowd, which was inconceivable 3 years ago.
So you've undergone a whole sort of transformation since becoming a furry.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, finding an enjoyable hobby can increase a person's overall confidence. Honestly, I've even noticed my own confidence in how I present myself has gone way up since I got my fursuit and started wearing it for this review series, and that's only been about 8 months.
Do you feel like for a lot of people, dressing up is also an opportunity to be more confident?
Definitely, especially in our group since we're in a military town. There's a lot of people that just can't break loose like that normally, and the mask gives you the chance to break out without feeling like you're breaking some kind of rule.
Running around and acting silly in public without a costume will definitely get you weird looks, but wearing a fursuit allows for that outlet without ruining one's reputation. The fursuit is a big signal to people on the street that, hey, this is just an act, they're not usually like this.
So, the time has come, Alex, for me to see who you really are. Hello?
Hi!
Hi!
I'm Alex, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Should we all get the heads off? Shall we?
Yes.
Well, it's nice to see you all.
In the past, furries have been pretty standoffish about working with the media because of the way we feel our fandom has been taken advantage of. But it seems that the tide is slowly but surely turning. Now let's check out the review stats. Information accuracy is 89%, and the spirit of the clip is 100%, giving us an average of 95%. And now time for my thoughts. When I was writing this review, I noticed that there were a lot of similarities between this video clip and Valerio Dives Under Fursuiting. Both had a host that took the time to learn a bit about furry culture, they both tried on a fursuit and went for an outing with a costume on, and both realized that fursuits get hot very quickly. The biggest similarity I see in both of the clips is their method of reporting. Both of the hosts in these clips adopted an immersive strategy in their reports and took a leap off the deep end into furry fandom. And it seems to pay off, as both of the hosts come away from their experiences with a better understanding of the fandom. In the case of this week's video clip, Billy seems to have gained a better understanding of how wearing a fursuit can be liberating and serve as an outlet for escapism. This clip did fail to mention that furries are people who are interested in cartoon animals first and foremost, and the costumes are just a part of that interest for select individuals. This is the only thing that kept this clip from getting a full score of 100%, but it is a misconception that's easily corrected. In previous years, furries have been pretty shy about cooperating with media because of the way we feel our fandom has been misrepresented. It does seem, however, as more media outlets are becoming more transparent about their methods and gaining awareness of the way furries feel about media coverage, furries are slowly but surely becoming more open to the idea of working with the media, and the media seems to be earning back the fandom's trust. It may still be a long way off before furries are truly comfortable working with the media, but media coverage like World of Weird's report will definitely help to pave the way. To Channel 4's World of Weird, and especially to Billy J.D. Porter, for your patience and willingness to jump straight off the deep end to get a better understanding of a pretty wacky subculture, I thank you. Well, that's it for today's episode of Furries in the Media. Have fun, stay awesome, bye-bye, and God bless us, everyone. Couldn't have said it any better myself, Sam. From our hearts to yours, happy holidays.